Hey guys, Doug here behind the camera, and we are here with Jeremy Mark with another Trucker King Tech with another one of his Taurus trucks. I know you guys always are asking questions about him, so Jeremy, let's take a close look at your Taurus Racer here.
Yep. So this is my newest Pro Mod. Last winter we did the initial one, which was an SMT10. That was what I was familiar with when I got into the hobby. But now we have this new chassis that's a prototype. On my Taurus Facebook page, I've posted about it, a few other guys have. This is an ACRC prototype shafty chassis. I don't believe he has a name for it yet, but a few of us are running them this winter to fine tune the setups. But it's this nice thick aluminum. It uses some of the same trays and components, sway bars from the Cloudbuster chassis, but you have this nice long shafty chassis, so you can get your sway bars just where you want them, your shocks just where you want them. And what's really nice about it is most of this truck was my SMT10 from last year that I built up, and you can just transfer it right over. So these are RH Designs short wheelbase kit links for the SMT10. These are AR60 axles, but these are the Vanquish aluminum housings. And the steering links and everything are the Vanquish Incision steering links that everybody's
stainless.
Using.
Yep.
And then we still have the Hot Racing transmission that's very common in here, aluminum one.
Yep, that's I know I got one of those in my truck. Those things they're great.
Yep. And then for landing, we have a few things that work together. There's the ProLine PowerStroke XT shocks that a lot of guys with shafties run, the 5-inch shocks. I've kind of changed the springs around so I can get it to land right for the weight of the truck. So these are actually G-Made zero shock springs, the white medium ones, just so I could get something that was light enough. And then also a lot of the guys are using the Crawler Innovations Deuces Wild Foams. Josh talked about those in one of his videos last winter.
Mm-hmm. And a lot I've of changed, guys running them.
Yeah, they're closed cell foams, and people think you want like a spongy foam in there, but actually, if you have that spongy foam, you'll get the rebound of the tire bouncing back with it. These harder foams, a little bit of air will sneak out, but it's almost like landing on a pillow. And then really all your landing is just on your shocks. And you can really get a good handle on these trucks, because when they drop, it just sticks.
Basically, it's your sprung weight is what's taking the suspension. Actually, it makes your suspension do the job. It doesn't have the tire do the job for the suspension. It creates a more stable environment for the tire. I guess real fast here before we go on this body, this body is the new J Concept Chevy, the modern Chevy, right?
Yep, this is it's 2014 that just came out a few months ago. They teased it at the Bigfoot open house, and I've been waiting all summer to get my hands on it. And then when Bob had the chassis, I was like, great, I don't have to cut out the bed and weaken it up. So yeah, what's great about this is it says it's 12.5-inch wheelbase, but this truck is 13.62-inch wheelbase right now. And at 13 inches, you can see this still.
Yeah, the wheel wells.
You just
wells.
Trim out the edges a little bit on the wheel wells or cut off the bumper. You can run an SMT10 stock wheelbase chassis or like 14-inch wheelbase will still work with this, even though it's a 12.5-inch wheelbase body. A lot of guys I see in the different online groups will ask, what do I need for a stock SMT10 for bodies? And it'll say, people will say go check out the wheelbase, but with this one, it really kind of undersells how long this can actually fit, because this still looks pretty nice in scale.
Yep, and those headers, I guess, are those RH Designs?
Yep, and those too, they came right off of the SMT10. The only thing I had to do, because the cradle doesn't angle in, I just put some spacers in there so they're recessed into the chassis like there's a real motor in there.
Oh yeah, I got you. So it's not right on the edge. It looks great. Can't really show that on the camera here, but you can see that the effect of it. So
yep. And then for power, the Graupner 5.5 or 6.5 is really common in our group. This is the 6.5 turn Graupner setup with the 120R Genius speed control. And then I also have a BEC. Some people heard that last summer I had a brownout during an event. So I always have BECs on my trucks now. Just
it was a runaway. Yeah, if you got you guys should have seen that on video.
Yeah,
the truck ran away into the
race,
field.
I broke a servo running into a turning car, and then when I went to change out the servo and recenter it, just took off in the background in the middle of an event.
It was not fun.
No. So now with all these high voltage servos, Some people get by with a Glitch Buster, but a BEC is a lot safer for these high torque ones, especially the Savixes.
I know I am personally a BEC man myself. I like BECs on my truck. So, all right, Jeremy, thanks a bunch. And we will see you next time for more Trigger King Tech.
Thank you.